Right, good morning ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video. If you don't already know, I'm Antonio, aka Antonio Roberto Vlogs, and on this channel I'll take you to the most beautiful places within Cape Town, take you to places that you'll find nowhere else in the world but here in the mother city of South Africa. Now if you love nature, if you're an adventurous person, or if you simply just love the outdoors, this video is definitely for you. Stay tuned, today is going to be a very epic day. We're doing one of Cape Town's most dangerous routes to take up to Table Mountain. It's called India Venster, but more of that after the intro. Here we go. Right, so India Venster. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the most dangerous routes to climb up to Table Mountain. We usually don't recommend people to do this route unless you have done it before, unless you're an experienced climber or you are with a tour guide, you know. I do not recommend anyone to take this pathway by themselves. It is quite dangerous. There's many incidents that actually happen on India Venster, so we do not want that to happen to you. So all I'm saying is rather get the tour guide, get someone who maybe did it already, and you know, just take it easy up here. Don't rush, no running, take your time, you know, and it is capable of doing. I'm here with my boys. We got the founder of Saucy Hoots. We got Riaze, aka Bones, yeah, in the building. Man of all talents, the jack of all trades. Oh, I always wanted to do India Venster though, and today is that day. Alright, so as you guys can see, this is the part where we're actually going to take up. Where, as you saw there, Table Mountain. So this is where you actually begin to go to India Venster. There's a pathway that actually leads to the contour path. Now, the contour path runs along the mountain. When you come to the point, to an intersection, there will be a green board showing India Venster going straight up. Left will be for Platte Cliff Gorge, and the right will go to Cliff Corner and so on. So yeah, this is actually where you want to start off when doing India Venster. Look out with a Table Mountain board, and you're going to have like a tester of steps going up just to warm the blood up, warm the legs up, and then after that, India Venster begins.
Right, so we made it to the contour path, guys. From here, India Venster actually starts. So this is only the beginning, coming all the way from the lower cableway station into the contour path. As you can see behind me, India Venster will be going straight and to your right all the way up. So from this point, that's where your time actually starts running for India Venster.
Letting Kayla know what of a beast India Venster is.
It is
a challenge, guys. So yeah, just make sure you have lots of water though. You're gonna need lots of water. Look at this, as Kaylin was saying, one mistake here, guys. One mistake, and you're down.
If you look over to your left, you see death. If you look over to your right, you'll see more death.
Please
be careful, stay alert, stay alive. Don't drink and drive or hike.
So the sun is pumping over here, guys. We're actually in the Venster, as you can see behind me. That's the window that I was speaking about. So yeah, I'll explain to you guys once we reach the top why this is actually called what it is. Take note of these yellow footprints, it will actually guide you. They're going in the right direction, okay? So when you do all coming up in the Venster, take note of that always and look out for those yellow footsteps onto the rocks. Wherever you see it, just follow that footsteps. That is actually leading you in the right direction. So check it, guys, even we started way too late to come up in the Venster, because we actually made it only to our first shading spot now. And it's hectic up here, yeah.
Choose
the right time as well. Be here about earliest, 5:30. 5:30 you should actually be climbing already, because the sun gets scorching on you. On India Venster especially, it's much worse than Plattekloof even. If you have done Plattekloof Gorge in the past. So yeah, how's it going, boys?
Good so far, bro.
Good so far. Taking it easy.
Indian Venster. India.
Thank you very much.
So this is actually the scrambling part that I was referring to, guys. The scrambling, or the climbing part, to put it in a simpler form, where you actually need to go up. So this is actually the hardest part of India Venster. So yeah, you actually need to be extra vigilant, and especially for those people actually filming, or want to actually film the hike up here, just be careful, be extra vigilant with your equipment, with yourself as well. Watch your step at all times, because there's quite a few loose rocks over here that I even actually almost slipped on. So just watch your step, and yeah, this is actually the hardest part. After this, we'll be almost at the top of the summit of India Venster, or say Table Mountain, of course, as it's part of Table Mountain. So yeah, let's do this. Summit of Table Mountain, 1067 meters above sea level. It's about 3500 feet, as I explained to you guys. By the way, if you haven't watched my previous vlog on Lion's Head Mountain, please do go check it out now. I will leave it in this corner, that corner there. One of the two, but yeah, check it out. And yeah, let's get them moving. All right, so check this out, guys. We're coming from this point all the way up. Okay, and it goes all the way up over there. But look at this way. This looks like a pathway as well, you see? So you can move all the way through. So that's where people actually get lost and they go the wrong way. And this is an incident happen, you understand? So please do take note of the yellow footsteps once again. And follow that, it will guide you in the right direction. So we're about to do the last of the scrambling. It's a nice one. I'm enjoying this.
Me too.
A lot, guys. You won't understand. Really, I thought it's going to be much worse. But actually, it's amazing.
It's amazing. Wow. Yes, like old pro, rocking his leg, Cooper. Hello.
I don't recommend this.
No. Get you a first aider with if you want to do this.
So if you are experienced climber and you are experienced logger and, you know, carrying equipment everywhere you go, go ahead, but please
don't
attempt this at all.
Okay, so we reached the part where you will find the staples. As I explained to you guys, this is support to actually climb up here. So yeah, this is where we'll be going up, as you can see.
Once again, guys, when climbing the staples, because you know it's risky, one wrong move can tumble all the way down. So this is another confusing part here, guys. Have a look. It actually looks like there's no direction that you're moving into, so don't think that you are lost. Just move along, follow the yellow footprints. Sometimes it's hard to actually see, so take note, be vigilant, and yeah, follow that. You can't go wrong.
Whew. Yeah, the scrambling is super exciting. It's not as scary as you think, but guys, once again, it's really easy. Okay, see that we actually made it to Broken Rock, guys. As I explained earlier on, many people hike up Indian Venster, but they don't actually know why they actually named it Indian Venster, you know. So yeah, I just wanted to explain to you guys. Sorry, I think my lens is a bit dirtier. Fix. Okay, there we go. So the real reason why they actually called it Indian Venster was, if you take a look at this actual pathway and the route and the shape of the mountain of Indian Venster, if you look at it from maybe a satellite view or a view on the map or maybe a drone view, it is actually shaped like India. You know what I mean, on the map. So that's why they actually called it India. And then, as I showed you guys earlier on the Venster part, which is a window in English, they basically just added those two words together, which is India Venster. For all the tour guides out there, let me know what your reason is. I'm sure there is much, much more myths and all of those things. Once you reach Broken Rock, you should know that you're always reaching the summit. You almost reaching the summit of Table Mountain. Via Indian Venster. I just want to show you where I'm sitting at the moment. Sheesh. Please do not try this. I'm just doing this for the shot that I want to get off the cable car. Hey, by the way, shout out to Table Mountain, man. Doing a great job, even though the pandemic, you know, is not on our side. This is actually another pathway coming up here, as you guys can see over here. That's when you do Kloof Corner, but that is, I would say, even more riskier than Indian Venster. But yeah, he's capable of doing. And obviously you're going to go all the way up and you will come up onto India Venster route as well. So once again, guys, on top of Table Mountain there's about over 5,000 different species of plants that you do see, and that all belongs to a family you all may be familiar with. That's called the Vaain family. So do also take note of the plants while hiking up. It's quite amazing. As you guys saw there, that we call the purple Watsonia that we just passed now. One of the popular plants on top of Table Mountain as well. We got different types of fynbos over here. You know what I mean? It's quite a huge amount of fynbos that we actually find over here. So take note of the small things and you will honestly really appreciate life more. Right, so that plant that I just showed you guys over there now, that we call the blister bush. Now, the blister bush is a very, very interesting plant as well. It has a defense mechanism on top of the leaf, so as soon as the first person comes along and they touch or come in contact with that blister bush, they usually activate this crystal substance that lies on top of the layer of this plant. Now, if nothing happens to them, the second person who then comes along and they come in contact with the blister bush, they usually get the brunt of the plant. Very unfortunate, but that's how it works. So usually, you'll at the start of it as a very itchy, irritating rash, and obviously you're going to be scratching and scratching, not knowing what it is. The sunlight makes it much worse as well, and eventually it'll turn into small little boils, and it can become a bit uncomfortable and, you know, a bit painful in that way. So in order to avoid that, just stay away from the blister bush while hiking up any trail on top of Table Mountain. Once you reach the summit of Table Mountain via India Venster, you will reach this intersection over here that you see behind me. So once you come off India Venster, which is just further this way, you'll be coming out over the side, okay, as you can see there. The intersection will be over the side, so this is to go down to Platteklip Gorge, which is just on over that side over there. Has to go down to Platteklip Gorge and McClear's Beacon. But if you guys are not walking down India Venster again and you want to take the cable way, you're going to come to this intersection. You have a look on this little plague over here. From there, you're going to go left all the way up to the cableway station. That takes you all the way up that steps over there, all the way down to the cableway station. And you can then use the cable car down if you guys are a bit too tired to hike back down. So we actually decided not to hike back down yet. We're going to head over to the Hely-Hutchinson Dam. As you guys saw in my previous video, if you haven't checked that, I will link it in either corner over here. Have a look at the five dams that we did off Table Mountain. But yeah, I think we're going to take a swim over there. That's super hot up on the mountain, so we want to take a quick dip in Hely-Hutchinson Dam and then, you know, head further back down. So if you do want to do Hely-Hutchinson from Table Mountain, head over to that intersection I spoke about. We do come up Platteklip Gorge as well as India Venster. I'm going to look for this McClear's Beacon sign over here, and you're going to head all the way to your right, all the way through. So yeah, once again, follow this yellow footprints as I explained to you guys. It will lead in the right direction.